Hey everybody, welcome back to Battle Ready Inc. So this week we're back on Classic Collection and we're looking at the new form of Edamon. Edamon finally got some support after being in this game for so long. Game's been out for a year, finally getting more support for it and looking really good. We decided to combine it with D-Brigade because D-Brigade's like the big hot kind of black tech options that you can go with and see how it performed. And then we matched it up against the new machine deck. This is still in its infancy, okay? I just want to clarify that. This is still the beginnings of dark black machines, okay? They're going to get better as sets come along. So once BT7 comes around and they get their secondary mega, I think the deck is going to like just completely change and be just so much more impactful. And I can't wait to play it then. So we're just kind of taking the beginnings of it, and we're just going to kind of throw it at you and see how it does. Don't forget, our memory marker for the month of December is Yokomon. This is handmade out of clay by my wife. Super adorable hand-painted face. Looks great. The little tendrils on top and everything. Very, very, like, highly detailed. Super adorable. Like I said, this is Patreon for December. Now, if you want any of our previous memory markers we've had on the channel, check the Ko-fi link in the description below. And there you can see all the previous memory markers we've had on the channel. The benefit, though, of going through Patreon is that you can get usually a discounted rate, often pretty much free shipping is what it equates out to, but only while it's the featured Digimon. So jumping over here, we got D-Brigade going first. They're using their baby there that gives them that plus 1,000. Dropping down the 5,000 DP Commandermon just to get things going. And then going to drop out the vanilla 2 play cost Commandermon. I'm seeing a lot of Commandermons in this one. Here, it looks like we're jumping the gun there. Hatching the baby, going into the new Pogumon. And now we see the toy Agumon just to kind of help with a little bit of draw power. And then they're going to evolve into the Silsdramon. This is just going to be that 6,000 DP blocker, the basic standard blocker that every color has. Now we're going to see the new Hagirmon here dropping for 3. Gets to discard a level 5 machine type and then draw 2. So very good draw power. And it sets up the trash for the late game Machine Dramon plays. So it looks like the Commandermons both coming into play here. Sees an opportunity before that blocker comes out. Going to go ahead and take it and start swinging into security. Get some early damage in. Oof. Hits into an early game tie, though. That's going to be rough. That's going to be a memory fixer as well as a 1,000 DP buff on the opponent's turn, which can be really good for a lot of defensive-style decks. Going to hit into the Machine Mamemon there, so just a 7,000 DP. And then now we see Edamon. Looks like they're just going to skip the level 4s and go straight into that level 5 Edamon. That's the one on deletion where you get to reveal the top 5 and find a metal Edamon. So double the metal Edamons now available. So there we see another Silsdramon. And here we see another Hagirmon. This is just the vanilla, though, that 2 play cost. And then I'm going to go into the new Gardramon. So 2 cost Evo, 6,000 DP, cannot attack. It's when attacking inheritable, though, is basically the same as that the new Hagirmon, where you can discard a machine. So I believe that'll come up. We'll just have to wait and see. Here we're going to see, yet another Edamon just getting hard played there. Just setting up a nice wall of blockers, at least. Both sides going very heavy on the defense. We're going to see another Hagirmon vanilla get played in raising there. And here we see the new Metal Tyrannomon for the deck. So it looks like it does miss the when digivolving effect there. Reveal the top 3. You can add a machine type to your hand. Trash the remaining cards. It could definitely bite them back later. We'll have to see. And then going to pass the turn with just a Chewmon. Doesn't look like it's Chewmon's going to be very relative right now. But we'll just have to wait and see if any kind of memory shenanigans come up. Black does have that new zero cost option that gives the on deletion gain 2 memory. That's pretty nice. Could be relevant with those Edamons, especially this one swinging in here. 6,000 DP. Looks like just trying to get ahead at this point. Gonna block with that Silsdramon. That tie gonna give it 1,000 DP. So Edamon not even gonna be able to crash. Definitely an interesting choice there on calls. Does get to get the Edamon trigger though. So real top 5, And if depending on how many metal Edamon is being played, like I said, there is a potential of having 8 in a deck. Seems a little heavy for Megas, but hey, you know, when you get to play them for free, I guess it kind of adds up. Ooh, seeing multiple Zwarts getting hit. There's a Commandermon, a Darkdramon, and a third Zwart. Ouch, that is not what they wanted to see. So total whiff on that Edamon. Didn't even get to take a Silgermon with it. That is going to be hard-pressed. Here we do see the Evo into the new Metal Edamon, though. So on the opponent's turn, it's going to gain some DP for every Edamon in the trash there. So it can get pretty beefy pretty fast. So very difficult to get run over. But doesn't matter. Not going to stay on the field anyway. Iron Fisted Onslaught. Just going to go ahead and remove it before it can start doing any damage. Looking like Machine Dramon's in a really good position. A really like big board there. But one misstep could really wipe that field out. We'll just have to wait and see what happens. Hey, an Iron Fisted Onslaught in reverse without that Metal Tyrannomon could spell disaster for all those Silstramon. Here we're going to see that Commandermon come up. Going to get promoted onto the field and evolved into the Nanimon there. That's the new security one for black. And then I'm going to hard play a Commandermon. That looks like the Ondeletion. So on deletion, he'll get to flip more of the top of the deck and get to play any Commandermon for free. One Commandermon. If it was all Commandermon, you could not play all of them. That would be incredibly busted. I think that would be like the ultimate meta deck for sure. Reveal top 4, play all Commandermon for free. Yikes. Here we're going to see a Hagiramon get evo'd here. And there we see the boss monster coming down, but just going into an Evo, not going to play it. Probably doesn't have enough in trash to really get the good value out of it. And with the 3 Evo, he can still swing with it, so that's pretty relevant. Going to go ahead and trigger that Gardramon we talked about earlier. Discard the level 5 to draw 2. That Metal Tyrannomon does give it reboot as well as the Inheritable. Here we're going to see, I believe that is the Megadramon there. That's going to do... on play, delete up to 2 of your opponent's Digimon with 3,000 DP or less. Could be kind of relevant with the current situation. Could have played it, but decided to Evo instead. Also has the Inheritable of Security Attack plus 1 for those machines. All right, we're going to see the new Edamon come down. This is the one that reduces the Evo cost of Metal Edamons coming down on top of it. So turn on those 3s into 2s, which is pretty nice. Metal Edamon, of course, being unblockable, as well as it gains 2,000 DP on the opponent's turn. Metal Edamon really, really good for just like swinging and taking games. Absolutely. Especially if the opponent forgets that it's unblockable. Yeah, that's going to spell disaster for sure. Machine Dramon swinging in, again, discarding 1 to draw 2, setting that trash up for a really, really nice play later. Just hits into a Commandermon, not really relevant. Swinging with that Chewmon, going to die to the Tankdramon, probably trying to bait out that blocker, it looks like. And there we do see, it looks like the block coming in on the Hygiramon. The Pogomon will trigger, which will reveal the top card. If it's black, add it to hand. Look at that massive hand size that they've got going there. So, and there we see the Machine Dramon coming down, 3 Evo cost. Gets to pick 2 Digimon and gives them reboot. Probably going to swing over, I would imagine, the Seals Dramon. No, just going to go for it. Has the Security Attack plus 1. Ooh, that Nanimon could be disastrous, though. Oh, and then hits into an Izzy. Was about to close the game out with those Silstramon about to swing for game. And an Izzy, if those are all black, that could swing tempo right back over to D-Brigade here. That's 1 black. That's 2 black. And that's 3. Yep. We saw all those Zwart go to the bottom earlier, so no whites were going to be in the way. And now they're going to reset it, stack it to how they want it. Ouch, though. Passes turn back. The game was in the grasp of Machine Dramon, just right there, almost had it. Of course, they hit into one of the only ways that could have possibly passed turn back to the opponent. That is pretty wild for sure. And then not only that, it is a memory fixer, so that'll put them back up to 3 memory. Do have 2 blockers, though, and 3 security still on Machine Dramon's side, so still in a very, very good position, I would say. Does look like they've got, 5 attacks coming in. So, could be disastrous. I don't think anything else there has blocker. No Andromons underneath those giving them blocker. Yeah, and neither of those Machine Dramons have reboot built in. All right, we're going to see that Edamon get evo'd there. Probably going to just, in case the attack doesn't go through quite so well. Deciding if they want to block or not here. Looks like they do go ahead and go with the sure thing. Don't want any shenanigans here. They will get to potentially get a free Commandermon. Looks like they've already revealed one, so more replacing off the top. Having a little difficulties there with Tabletop Simulator. And they do hit the one Commandermon, and the rest will go to the bottom of the deck there. No Izzy and Joe. I'm sure they would probably appreciate that decently well at this point. Although, very much in a tight spot, I don't think there's any time to be wasting playing Tamers at this point. Definitely seems like an all-or-nothing kind of turn here. Still got a decent amount of attacks here. Now we're going to see that Edamon come in. Going to have to debate the block or not. If you block and it dies, they could risk another Metal Edamon coming in for free here. More difficulties. They are using a laptop to play with just the mouse pad. Yeah, that's that's a pain. Trying to play this game with no mouse is very difficult. We will see the Edamon die, though, anyways, without the block. And we could be seeing more Metal Edamons coming into play here. So there we see the blocker Commandermon. There's the monkey. He's going to be coming into play. So just every time they hit into something, just gets replaced immediately. And that's what you want to see in this deck. We didn't see it early on with that first Edamon, but we have seen it with the since then. So that's really, really predominant of just replacing all of your value every time you swing. That Metal Edamon there swinging in, it is unblockable. Here we're going to see the Commandermon swinging in. Probably going to get blocked here, it looks like. Yes, it is. Pogumon there, though, so on deletion, you get to reveal that top card of the deck. And if it's black, you get to add it to hand, which is just really good, again, replacement value. So, you know, replace off of your deletion, that is a Metal Edamon, will get added to hand. So either you get a replace on field, or you can replace, you know, with hand value. So either way is very good. And then we're going to see that Sealsdramon coming down. Oh, to pass turn there. Very unfortunate. The only play I could have saw that could have worked there, if they had swung with everything, if they had a Dark Dramon in hand while they were at 3, if they didn't evo into that Edamon, they dropped the Dark Dramon, they could have won it, I think, off of that. They would have swung for game, I believe, with the Seals Dramon. Here we're going to see that Machine Dramon coming in. Going to get blocked by the first one, and then swinging in with the second Machine Dramon, clearing out that one, and then swinging for game, finally, with the Seals Dramon that they wanted to do last turn. But yeah, that's going to close the game out very, very close. Like I said, that the very last turn for the Edamon player, if they had swung with everything except for their Seals Dramon, played a Dark Dramon for normally 13, it would have been reduced down to 3, and swung and cleared out the very last one. They could have, I believe, swung for game, if I'm not mistaken, off of the Seals Dramon there. We'll just back it up and double check, make sure I'm not saying the wrong thing. So the starter turn there, they're going to promote up. So if they had swung with both rookies here, both blockers would have taken it. And then they could have swung with the Nanimon, hit a security, and then swung with the Metal Edamon, taking out another security. Played the Dark Dramon, would have gone to 0 memory, swung for that last security with the Dark Dramon, and then swung for game right there. I think that would have been their best shot for sure. And unfortunately, we didn't get to see the hard-played Machine Drummond. Definitely had the setup ready to just unleash in a lot of the games that we played. Unfortunately, the best game that where both sides really got to pop off like completely equally, we got to see the Machine Drummond come down. That game didn't get recorded, unfortunately. It was very awesome, though, getting to see this guy come down and just stack up completely. Also, make sure you do your stacks in the correct order, because Ultimate Flare was played a few times, also hitting Security, I believe, once, and got hit on the Machine Drummond there, took it all the way, you know, took it down multiple levels there. So whatever you have at the very bottom, those are going to be your most important ones. So if you want to Digivolve right back into a Mega on the following turn, make sure that you're going to have your best inheritables at the very bottom, or at least whatever's the most relative, you know, Reboot, Blocker, or something like that. Piercing with Security Attack plus one, although I think the Security Attack plus one isn't... Oh, no, it is. The Mega Drummond there. Yeah, just got to make sure you get your Evos underneath in the right stack, especially against playing against a black deck or a security control deck. Definitely going to be very, very relative. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you would, please like the video and subscribe. Just a little bit of help goes a super long ways. It helps the channel out tremendously, gets my videos out there, gets them seen. And if you really, really want to support the channel, check out the links in the description below. I'll have a link for my Patreon, which is displayed right here. You can get access to my Discord server that I have, as well as you can get the memory markers that we've had. These are just a few of my favorites from the past that we've had. The current one, Impmon's baby, as well as Gabumon's baby as well. Sunomon and Yamon. These guys are super adorable. I definitely love them so much. And every month, a new one changes out. So make sure you check that out. As well as we have our new playmats. This is why I recreated this video. It's because our playmats are here finally. And they are super cool. I alternate between the black and white every single month for whoever wants to support this tier. As well as I have a tier just higher than that. So that way you don't also have to lose out on a memory marker. You can get both the memory marker and the playmat just in case you want both. Super awesome support from everyone that has supported in the past and who will support in the future. You guys are awesome. Also, if you want to check out my merch, my Teespring link is in the description below for that. We've got, you know, the shirts that I wear on the channel that has the logo across. I love when I see people representing my merch in public. It is like one of the coolest feelings I've ever had in my entire life. Very, very awesome. As well as phone cases for you people that love Digimon like so much like I do. A friend of mine custom made all these to fit these specific phone cases themselves. So the prices are a little bit higher just because I have to pay her back, as well as make a little tiny bit of profit because of how much, unfortunately, they take for their cut for Teespring. But like I said, if you can't do any of that, please just like the video and subscribe to the channel. Every time we hit a new mile marker for subscriptions, I give out free merch of all different types. 2000K, I think we're doing one of the playmat giveaways. So definitely be subscribed and ready for when that comes.